The Philippine Finance Chief discusses investment opportunities with his Singaporean counterpart. Secretary Benjamin Diokno spoke Thursday with Singapore's Lawrence Wong at the sidelines of the ASEAN Finance Ministers and Central Bank Governors meeting in Indonesia. The Philippine Finance Department says the two also tackled improving cooperation between Manila and the city-state on tourism as well as digital finance. Aside from Wong, Diokno also met with Asian Development Bank's President Masatsugu Asakawa. Included in their discussion, ADB's priority areas of support to the Philippines. Chipmaker NVIDIA warns that further U.S. export curbs on its chips to China could end the ability of American semiconductor firms to compete in one of the world's largest markets. Reports suggest Washington is considering new export restrictions on artificial intelligence-related chips, the likes which NVIDIA designs. Now, this follows rules introduced last year that restricted NVIDIA from selling its top-end graphics processing units to Beijing. NVIDIA previously introduced chips which are modified and slowed down hardware to comply with the U.S. rules. Despite this, the chipmaker's stock has rallied more than 220% this year, and the company is expecting revenue growth to nearly triple year-on-year in the September quarter. All eyes on Jerome Powell this Friday as America's Monetary Authority chief speaks at a gathering of central bankers and economic leaders in Wyoming. Investors will be on the lookout for cues from Powell's Jackson Hole speech on the Fed's policy direction. Reuters quoting analysts from Bank of America saying the markets may be ill-prepared for a hawkish tone from Powell. The said speech is happening later this Friday evening, Manila time. Taking a look now at the major stock indices, tech and retail stocks dragging Japan's Nikkei 225 down to lead Friday's decline in the Asia-Pacific region. Investors there are also assessing the latest core inflation data in Tokyo, which cooled to its lowest in a year at 2.8%. The Chinese market also following Japan in the red with the Hang Seng down by 1%. Let's take a look now at futures in Europe. They are pointing to a mixed open as focus turns to the Jackson Hole Symposium. The German DAX seen opening 0.3% lower after second quarter GDP numbers showed Europe's biggest economy stagnated in the April to June period. Although the zero growth for the quarter pointed to Germany exiting recession, on an annual basis, GDP contracted 0.2%. Over on Wall Street, futures are also mixed. Aside from Fed Chief Powell's speech, investors are also watching out for consumer sentiment data. The BRICS bloc of developing nations welcomes new members in the push to reshuffle world order. BRICS, which stands for Brazil, Russia, India, China, and South Africa, agreed to admit Saudi Arabia, Iran, Ethiopia, Egypt, Argentina, and the UAE. This is the bloc's first expansion in 13 years. BRICS leaders also left the door open to more additions in the future. Chinese President Xi Jinping, the proponent of the bloc's expansion, says the enlargement shows the determination of BRICS countries for unity and cooperation with other developing nations.
In the first half of the year, public works spending in the Philippines stood at 507 billion pesos. Now, that figure is 5% higher than the programmed expenditure for the period. The budget department said most of the spending went to rail and road projects. Overall, government spending for the first half was almost flat at 2.41 trillion pesos and was 6.6% below the programmed 2.58 trillion peso expenditure. The state's spending target is equivalent to 21.3% of gross domestic product this year, while overall infrastructure disbursements will be equivalent to 5.3% of GDP. As for bank lending growth in the Philippines, it slowed down in June. Data from the Philippine Central Bank show outstanding loans of big banks in June amounted to 10.99 trillion pesos, representing a 7.8% increase year-on-year. That loan growth, however, is slower than the previous month's 9.4% and marks the third straight month of decline. The BSP attributed this decrease to the high interest rate environment. The Philippine Central Bank urged to raise or, if possible, remove the interest rate cap on credit card transactions. This remark from Credit Card Association of the Philippines after the BSP kept the rate ceiling unchanged at 3% per month. The BSP says the move sought to strike a balance between providing consumers with access to credit card financing at steady rates while ensuring long-term viability of credit card issuers.
Actually, the rate cap will be reviewed every 6 months. So that's according to the circular issued by BSP. So we're expecting that maybe in the next review, they might consider raising it a little bit. All that 3%, we're quite happy where we are today. Although we can do a little bit more. We'd rather that they totally take out the cap so that, you know, just leave the interest rate setting to the market forces, which is what it used to be before.
Innovation-related intellectual property filings in the Philippines increase in the first half of the year. The country's IP office says patent and industrial design filings grew year-on-year almost every month during that period. Most patent applications are geared towards pharmaceuticals, as well as organic fine chemistry and digital communications. IPO Philippines Chief Roel Barba now says patent activities are on track to reach a new record high this year, adding 2023 is shaping up to be a year of innovation. The agency also vowed to continue vigorously promoting IP protection. Ayala Corporation signs an agreement to establish a joint venture with a unit of Globe and Taiwan-based Gogoro Network to launch electric scooters in Metro Manila. The deal covers the importation, sale, distribution, and maintenance of Gogoro two-wheeled scooters and the establishment of battery swapping stations. Ayala said it entered into an agreement to subscribe 42 million common shares of Gogoro for a 21% stake. Gogoro Global, meanwhile, will own 60 million common shares, or 30% of Gogoro Philippines. 917 Ventures of Globe Telecom will own 98 million shares of 49% of Gogoro PH. IT company Accenture says, contrary to fears, generative AI will displace workers. That technology can actually help address unemployment and underemployment in the Philippines. How exactly? Let's find out in this report by Andrea Taguines.
We work with our partners.
Imagine being an accountant tasked to update your client's digital tax management system despite having zero experience with coding. Well, with generative artificial intelligence, you can do so with just a few magic words.
I'll just tell, you know, the AI, hey, create me a code for this new tax bracket. There you go.
Like asking a human.
That's just one of the many ways Gen AI can help people do their jobs, as demonstrated to the media by Accenture Philippines. And according to the company's latest survey, many firms in the country are willing to train their employees to use these kinds of technology to improve their productivity. In fact, 7 out of 10 organizations already have specific employee training programs planned out this 2023. Accenture Philippines Country Managing Director Ambet Tiero said, "This is because the human element is crucial to optimize the benefits from Gen AI." She said human touch is key to guard against hallucinations or times when the AI makes mistakes.
So our own clients, they're working with us to use our platform to train their own people because part of the value that we want to deliver to our clients when we do a transformation with them is to also enable their people. Because the tech will be useless if their people cannot use it.
So we've organized hackathons and learning sessions with those clients. So there is that willingness on our clients' part, even not just in the global locations, but even here in their locations in the Philippines.
Gen AI itself can be used to train people.
They're learning about this new function that's being rolled out, right? Rather than having to read a manual, we actually have the AI read the manual and all the documentation and create an automated FAQ, and again, a chatbot functionality to do Q&A with the person being trained as well.
That's why when done right, Tiero believes the adoption of Gen AI can help address both unemployment and underemployment in the country.
You know, 60% of the the roles, the job roles that we have today did not exist in 1940. So I think that we will keep creating new jobs for ourselves because the technology is evolving. So in particular in Gen AI, 2 years ago, there were no prompt engineers. And now it's a job description on LinkedIn. So we will not only just hire people who are already skilled, but using our resources, we will also invest in talents like what you describe, where they may not necessarily have the foundation or context yet.
Based on Accenture's July survey, 99% of C-suite executives plan to grow their investments in AI in the next 2 years, as they believe it would make them and their workers more competitive. Andrea Taguines, ABS-CBN News.
Philippine Congressman Joey Salceda pushes for lower taxes for stock transactions to boost investments. He says a more dynamic stock market will help boost SSS and GSIS pensions. The House Ways and Means Committee chairman adds, upon instructions from the president, he filed House Bill number 8958, or the Capital Markets Efficiency Promotion Act, which will cut taxes on stock transactions from 0.6% to just 0.1% of stock value. It will also cut the tax on dividends of foreign non-residents from 25% to 10%. The proposal also imposes a tax on debt instruments of 0.1%, in parity with the reduced rate for stock transactions. Salceda says the Philippine Stock Exchange has the fewest listed companies in ASEAN. And since SSS and GSIS have strict investment policies that limit their stock exposure almost exclusively to Philippine index stocks, if stocks don't move in value, the funds also stagnate.